There was always a bit of a Pittsburgh-Washington rivalry.
Ovechkin, major lip service between the two.
He's a good player, but, you know, he's talked too much.
He likes to run around these days. I don't like it personally, but that's him.
Everybody talking Ovechkin, Crosby, Ovechkin, Crosby.
It seems like we took it to another level, and I think everyone wanted that.
It's always a Alex versus Sidney type thing.
Probably the two best players in the world.
Ovechkin, a shot, he scores! A hat trick! Packed into the air, and they score!
Sidney Crosby has a hat trick.
Ovechkin, he scores! Carried on by Crosby, crosses over and shoots, he scores! Here's a chance, scores! He got a chance to split the D. Here he comes to the goal, he scores!
Sidney Crosby!
There's Ovechkin, he scores!
Here comes Sid. Crosby, spin around.
Shot scores! Ovechkin wide, fires, he scores! Alex Ovechkin!
Oh, slap me, semi, Sidney!
Closing in,
score! Ovechkin fires and scores!
Alexander Ovechkin. Sidney Crosby. The leading men on hockey's biggest stage. Barely in their 20s, but already legends in the making. And we ride the wave.
They're both tremendous athletes. The thing I like the most about both of them is they love the game and they play with passion.
Superstars with an appeal that extends beyond the game, across two continents.
He's this individuality that is really just Alexander Ovechkin. And he's developed his own brand. It really is contagious.
One is fire. One, quiet finesse. Both dazzling, but oh, so different.
That he likes his private life, keep things simple. Doesn't like the flash.
They're a marketer's dream, turning celebrity into millions. But that's not what we love to talk about.
There's no doubt who the better player is, Sidney Crosby.
I think I'll pick Ovechkin.
We usually don't have stud players like this, and we're just like, thank God, you know?
I don't think Ovechkin's gonna do anything. I think it's gonna be all Crosby this year.
I don't know what we'd do without Sidney Crosby.
Giuliano came to us and he said, you can bring this kid anytime on the show.
This is character. He's very polite. He's very nice to his fans.
He's a wonderful role model for the youth of Canada.
Ovechkin is a person who individually you fear because of what he's able to do with the puck.
You see that explosive passion in here when he plays. In fact, whole family is hooked up now.
Sid the Kid versus Alexander the Great. Time to pick sides. Who's better? Who's cooler? Who has the best shot at Olympic gold? We do love our superstars. We can't get enough of them. There's no magic in what makes them tick. They do what they do because there's nothing else in this world that they love like this.
I feel pretty fortunate to play a game that's so important to so many people.
If you have lots of money, some guys just think, okay, life is good and you can stop doing what you have to do. I'm not that guy. I just want to be a good hockey player.
I grew up loving hockey. Ever since I got into the league, I've, you know, tried to do my best to take my responsibility and make sure that I do my part.
It used to be just the hockey fans, but now they're hunted by the popular media. Always under the microscope, like Hollywood celebrities and rock stars. Ovechkin cultivates an image that's part grunge, part kid, who's still growing up.
You know, if I want to do something, I'm going to do it. It's who I am.
What's Wayne Gretzky coming doing here?
Ever since Alexander has entered the league, he was in somewhat of an enigma. He's created just a charisma that's attracted a lot of fans. I like to call it the mythology of Alexander Ovechkin.
And he is one of the most flashy, flamboyant, animated, vocal,
unfiltered players in the NHL today.
Rockstar status.
Rockstar status.
Thank
you.
Flashy, irreverent, and always unique. Ovechkin writes his own script, and we love him for it.
Sidney's not that type of guy. He's not the type of person off the ice than Ovechkin is, so. But Sidney, you know, he wants to score goals just as bad as Ovechkin wants to score goals, even though he doesn't jump up and down and hit the glass after every goal. He just shows in different ways, and he's more of a controlled motion, maybe, and off the ice, he's more, a little more private than Ovechkin is, I think.
Those who've known Sidney Crosby a long time aren't surprised that the money and the fame haven't really changed him.
I think that people respect him for the ability, it's what he stands for. And I think it goes hand in hand with his character of who he is in all aspects of his life and his game.
He's won a lot of awards, accepted graciously, and always with a thank you for those who got him here.
I have to thank my family for the sacrifices you guys have made throughout my whole life to be in this position. I appreciate it. Thank you.
The 2007 Hart Trophy is only one of three that he will take home this night.
With his first Pearson, Sidney Crosby becomes the youngest recipient in the history of the award.
The youngest ever. Sidney Crosby has heard that many times in his career, and so has Alexander Ovechkin. Since their rookie year, one or the other always seems to be at the podium during NHL awards.
Too hot, actually. Thank you very much. Next year, Stanley Cup will be ours.
What a life. Thank you.
They've been cast as rivals, examined and compared since the first day they skated on NHL ice. And last season, the intense competition between them was obvious from the start. Star break in late January, the season is shaping up to be a joke. Crosby is hurt and can't make the party in Montreal. Alex has the crowd all to himself. And boy, does he ham it up. This is what the fans came to see. Classic Ovechkin.
Describe him as an extreme extrovert. I don't think it's ever boring when Ovechkin is around.
And he promises there's more to come.
I feel this team can win Stanley Cup. Nobody can beat us.
3 months later, Washington and Pittsburgh meet in round two of the playoffs. Sid and Alex head to head. One will go to the conference final, the other goes home. The hype is enormous, and what the games deliver is just as big. It's the best hockey played all year, a wild ride of ups and downs.
For me, I think the most important thing was just to focus on what I had to do and probably just not to let all of the, I guess, the hype between myself and Alex kind of affect what I did.
The series has it all, the hits, the goals, even a pair of hat tricks, one each in the same game. Six games end in deadlock.
For me, that was my first Game 7, so I wasn't sure how I was going to react to it. It's hard to really kind of grasp what you're feeling. I just remember knowing that, you know, just basically leave it all out there and see what happens.
But in the seventh and deciding game, Pittsburgh is just too good. Crosby advances. Ovechkin and Washington are gone.
It's always hard when you lose that kind of game, but you know, it's life, and sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, and you have to learn from that.
The year before, Crosby found himself in the same empty place after losing in the Stanley Cup final.
This is a tough one, getting this close and not winning the cup. But I know it'll make our team even stronger. I never want to be in this photograph again.
Who knew at that time when we did that ad after your first year that this was going to occur again against Detroit?
This time, a different ending. After beating Washington, Crosby and the Penguins go all the way.
He really believed that, hey, we're going to win this thing. I think that shows a lot of experience and maturity.
Sid the Kid became the youngest captain ever to hoist Lord Stanley's Cup. This was now his team, as surely as it had once been Mario Lemieux's.
I was here in Cole Harbour, like most of the fans were, and watching on the big screen at Cole Harbour Place, leaning against the wall where he took his first steps. Now I watch him raise the Stanley Cup. It's pretty special.
They close the season in Pittsburgh with a champions parade down Main Street. But Crosby was already thinking about the next big matchup. The Olympic Games in 2010 will reignite the old rivalry between Canada and Russia, and the world will be watching. Sid the Kid versus Alexander the Great, round two. Being a superstar means you're never really off the clock. But then again, the rewards are spectacular. If you put a decimal point between the 8 and the 7 on Sidney Crosby's jersey, that's how many millions he makes every year. Alexander Ovechkin has a 13-year contract valued at $124 million. The fattest in NHL history.
Yeah.
And there's more to come. A new deal with IMG will take Alex further into the global marketplace, adding more endorsements to his existing ones. Las Vegas. Big lights, big money, big stars. 2K Sports has brought Ovechkin here to make him the marquee player in a new video game. And we're not talking just the photo on the cover.
We really had to elevate ourselves to come up with ideas that matched Alex Ovechkin.
They dress him in what's called a motion capture suit to copy his style and signature moves.
Motion capture technology allows us to track an individual's motions. So what we do is we put these feature points, or in this case, these reflective white markers all over their joints. We've got 60 cameras. Each camera will basically act as a video camera and record where those white dots, those markers are on a person's body. And then a computer will then reconstruct all of those video feeds together and then recreate the 3D representation of that person's body. We can then recreate how a person moves. Obi do his certain, you know, celebration or a particular deke, that motion goes onto the game character and it behaves and acts exactly as he does.
I love hockey, I love playing video games, I love, you know, I love this atmosphere, and it's still fun and it's still a great time.
2K picked Ovechkin because right now he's the hot property for a generation of gamers.
When fans play the game and they're controlling Ovi and he scores, they see him celebrating like this and they feel like it's actually real.
To launch the new game, marketers came up with something splashy. A stunt to make even Ovechkin blush.
We were able to shut down the city of New York. We had help from the New York City police officers, and we had Alex driving a Zamboni for the first time in traffic down 6th Avenue in New York, right to the NHL store.
Oh, I'm already broken. Okay, I'm ready. I'm professional.
You know you've arrived when you can get New York City to shut down 6th Avenue for a joyride.
Okay, so what I have to do? People, come in. Buy something, come on. I need some money.
Then, Ovechkin plays himself, playing himself.
Oh, okay. What am I doing?
You know, you don't want to beat him and make him look bad, but you also want to beat him to make yourself look good.
Penalty shot. Let's do a penalty shot.
We'll get you suited up and we'll get you out here.
We're gonna start with some close-ups. If you can just have your body kind of arc this way.
You'll hear me, you just won't see me.
Take it off.
While Alex loves the flash, when it comes to the media spotlight, Sid would always prefer less. He can be fiercely private, so marketing him requires a delicate touch.
I'd rather be spending more time at the rink than, I guess, a studio shooting commercials.
He doesn't want to be walking billboard, but he understands his role with kids as a role model with adults, and he takes it very seriously.
For guys who've kind of been chosen to do things, it's, you know, it's something that comes with the territory, and you know what, I appreciate it, and I don't ever take it for granted.
Crosby just doesn't go looking for exposure. So when he agreed to a photo piece for GQ magazine in his second season, this was a side of the kid we'd never seen before.
He got teased a bit about it afterwards. A lot of the girls were happy about the article.
He's got more endorsement offers than he could possibly agree to. But if he's selective, he's also very loyal, especially when it's something he believes in.
I don't control the bumps and the bruises. I don't control the bounces, the shootout order. There are a lot of things in life I don't control. But then again, there are some things that I do.
Yes, he really did play Tim Hortons hockey. And he's stuck by the brand ever since, because he supports their development of grassroots hockey in Canada.
It's important for him to understand the brand and like the brand. Otherwise, it's not about the money in the end.
Sid had to be convinced to back any Crosby products. But in this game, merchandising comes with the territory.
Sidney, if he had his brothers, wouldn't want to sit down and sign things. He knows that he has to cater to this market. Sidney is the number one seller by far in hockey. And if he has to do that, then he wanted to pick a company that was going to do it the right way.
And it's big business. Upper Deck produces and markets hockey trading cards. Crosby appears on more than 1,263 different cards. And Ovechkin's not far behind, with 1,058.
A Crosby rookie card worth $10,000. That's one of our premier hockey products. And Ovechkin's at $4,500. Now, the fact that Sidney has won a Stanley Cup this past year has factored into Sidney's card being higher in demand now.
Sid's Stanley Cup card is the newest addition to be released, just in time for Christmas. They are in the marketing business after all. Reebok's deal with Crosby ranges from clothing to high-performance hockey equipment. It's a long-standing affiliation that lets him shoot some of his commercials back home in Nova Scotia.
This was my prom, my spring break, semester abroad. What do you call a life dedicated to hockey? I'd call it time well spent.
Time spent on ice rinks, almost from the day he could walk. It was no different for a Russian kid named Alex. And though they grew up on opposite sides of the world, they were destined to cross paths. Alexander Ovechkin and Sidney Crosby had met before on international ice half a decade ago at the World Junior Championship.
The international tournaments that they start playing against one another from, you know, under 17 and under 16 at times. Top players of each country are now starting to face one another. They also recognize, you know, what their weaknesses are. In order for me to achieve to the next level, I've got to be better than the guy that's opposite me.
Crosby had been waiting to play for Canada a long time.
When he was 15, a year before the World Juniors, Team Canada's training camp was in Halifax. He asked them to be the water boy. And he wanted to watch the practices and how the players behave. He was preparing himself to be on that team.
It wasn't the first time Ovechkin had played for his country and felt the pressure that comes with it.
Olympic Games, World Championship, or it doesn't matter what tournament. I want to represent my country.
The Canadian and Russian teams burned through the competition, setting up a showdown for the gold medal.
You know, for me, that's the matchup that always comes to mind when you think of, you know, Canada's rival. You know, it's Russia.
But the game within the game is the matchup between Crosby and Ovechkin.
I heard about him. I heard he's a good player, but I never seen him before. So when I have a chance to see him, I said, he's a really good player.
You know, could tell that he was a pretty dominant player. We all felt this was going to be the biggest test as far as individual players were concerned.
There's no doubt that they were both competing for this gold medal. Both players knew where the other one was on the ice.
The final game is close for a while. But Canada seals it in the second period when Ovechkin gets hurt and leaves the game.
You know, being a part of that team, that's a special team. You know, living out your dream of winning a gold medal at the World Juniors, something I, you know, had watched every year since I could remember.
Crosby is younger than most of the players. Too young to go pro. But Ovechkin is a year older, and every scout in the NHL has an eye on him.
The Washington Capitals are pleased to select Alexander Ovechkin.
I was not surprised. I'm expected to be number one. I have one dream. I follow this dream all the time. So when I come here to NHL, I just want to be the best, and I do my best.
But his best would have to wait. It was the year of the NHL lockout, and nobody played at all. Crosby's draft comes after the lockout. For the first time in NHL history, there's a lottery to start the draft, and bingo balls decide which team gets to pick first. It's known as the Sidney Crosby Sweepstakes.
They closed the street off because there was camera crews outside and satellite trucks. It was just a circus outside. It was nuts. We were just watching the television like everyone else, not knowing what was going to happen the next couple of hours. A big day in his life, because that lottery ball falls down, this is where he's going to start his career.
Pittsburgh wins the lottery.
Pittsburgh Penguins select from Rimouski, the Quebec Major Junior League, Sidney Crosby.
I remember leaning over to another fellow scout at the time and saying, this young man they drafted, I said, you guys probably don't realize, but I coached him a number of times. I said, don't be surprised if the Pittsburgh Penguins win a Stanley Cup in the next 3 to 5 years.
So the stage is set. Crosby and Ovechkin both play their rookie season in 2005. And the two of them put on a show. It's a treat for the fans, but for their respective teams, it's a lifesaver.
This kid's a star every time. The passion level that he brings to the ice is awesome.
At that time, they wanted to sell the team, and they didn't have the funds to build a new stadium. Pittsburgh was going like this.
After Crosby was drafted, the Penguins sold more tickets in August than they had the entire previous season. It's a similar story in Washington. Ticket sales go up, and Ovechkin jerseys and memorabilia sell like crazy.
He's the greatest thing that's ever happened to our franchise.
When the first season is done, the only question is, which one was the more spectacular rookie?
The Calder Memorial Trophy, Rookie of the Year.
From the Pittsburgh Penguins, Sidney Crosby. Youngest player ever to tally 100 points in a season.
From the Washington Capitals, Alexander Ovechkin. A one-man highlight reel. 106 points. Led all rookies in scoring.
And the Calder goes to
Alexander Ovechkin.
First of all, I want to say thanks, Sidney and Jan. Great season. You're great players, guys, and good luck in the future.
Ovechkin and Crosby were now hockey's best ambassadors. Not since Wayne Gretzky had the NHL found anything that could sell the game like Sid versus Alex. By the time they're both selected to their first All-Star team, they're superstars on the ice and off.
I like to order some food. How many people in the room?
Just me.
3 pizza.
4 chicken fingers.
2 meatloaf dinner.
6 large french fries.
I need some sausage.
Go!
5 lobsters. Lots of ketchup. Chicken corn dogs. My name? Sidney Crosby.
Ovechkin.
I can't do it.
The rivalry is a marketer's dream. After the bitter business of the lockout, for the league and the fans, hockey was back.
They're two phenomenal players, and they're both very selfless in trying to do what they can to grow the sport, which is fantastic for us.
Sid the Kid's 21st year ends with a birthday party that's the dream of a lifetime. Honoring one of hockey's great traditions, his gift is to bring the Stanley Cup home. From start to finish, the day is pure Crosby. It starts with a show of respect for the men, women, and families of the Canadian Forces.
The fact that you've chosen to share this day with the men and women of the Canadian Forces is a tribute to your class, your commitment to the game of hockey, to your country.
Then a private breakfast to say thanks to all his former coaches, including Paul Gallagher. A return to the IWK Children's Hospital to bring the cup to them. There's a fundraiser where all 87 lucky winners have their picture taken with Sid and the cup. And then, what else but a road hockey game?
I always was in that for some reason. I always played goalie since we started playing road hockey together. I grew up with these guys and we played the exact same way we did today since we were 5 or 6 years old.
This time, there are a few thousand spectators and the Stanley Cup is at stake.
You can't lift above your head, but you can go accept it.
You know, the minute I found out that, you know, you could bring the cup, or if you want it, you got a day with it, that's something I always set up. You know, I've got to do that.
Finally, a parade through the streets of Cole Harbor, which has suddenly ballooned to a population of 50,000.
This is incredible. You know, I've ran through this in my mind so many times, and as much hope supportive as much as I've gotten over the last few years here, it's been incredible, but this says it all right here.
Before the night finishes, Sid arranges for a free concert to be played by Sam Roberts. And you know things are going right when it rains, but just long enough to produce a rainbow that arches from one end of Cole Harbor to the other. Before the summer's out, the Penguins team and the Cup have one other visit to make, to Washington. In hockey season, this is Ovechkin's town, but Crosby makes it to the White House first.
This is by far the most fun thing that I'm doing today. Welcome to the White House, the world champion, Pittsburgh Penguins, with their third Stanley Cup. Can I just make one more point? Sidney must be really fast, because there are some big hockey players, and he's not one of them.
Not far from the White House is the Washington Convention Center. And today, this is Alexander Ovechkin's house. It's the annual Washington Capitals Fan Fest, an event to crank up the fever in what used to be an unlikely hockey market. There's a chance to get close and even throw out a few questions to Alex and his teammates.
Can you just do your Don Cherry impression?
Look at Ovechkin, he's a clown. He's Russian. Russian's stupid. Russian can't play hockey. Look at him.
The fans and the sea of red merchandise are sure signs that Washington hockey has never been healthier.
I have like the channel at school to watch every hockey game. It's like, that's how important it is to me now.
I just knew this was my game. This is my building. This is my team.
What we're witnessing is history been made right now, thanks to Alex Ovechkin.
Then Ovechkin is back on the road for another event, a product launch in Toronto. Ovechkin is the new face of the latest Energizer battery campaign. It's called the Power of Eight.
We'd use the expression that he has the bunny inside. He's full of energy. He goes with determination and intensity. He's really bringing hockey to a new level.
As a big kid himself, Ovechkin always has time for a quick game, especially when it comes with a check for his charity. Ovi's Crazy Eights for Underprivileged Kids.
It's very good to
For any judges, they donate money for kids to play hockey. And after the season, I'm coming here and play with the kids. So thank you very much. Enjoy the day.
Then more. More photos, more fans, more corporate obligations, and always more autographs.
They want a piece of me sometimes, but you know, it's, you know, the same like some famous person. And I don't want to talk to him. I just want to make a photo or a signature. It's normal things, I think. You know, it's obligations, but it's my part of my life.
When you're a star, everyone wants a piece. But right now, Ovechkin has a date in Moscow he wouldn't miss for the world. Moscow, summer of 2009. The Russian hockey team's Olympic training camp, and the rink is loaded with talent.
They're reigning two-time world champions.
Malkin, Ovechkin, Datsyuk.
Some of their best players are the elite players in our league right now.
Going into the tournament, they're probably the favorite.
The media attention and the passion for the game is just as intense here as it is in Canada. Everyone on the Russian team, directors, coaches, players, they're all in the same pressure cooker. And the one they hope will lead them to Olympic gold is number 8.
Everybody wants to play for the country, and I'm a lucky guy. I was playing the World Championship a couple of times, so I won the Olympic Games, and you know, that experience helped me a lot.
Это олимпийский чемпион. Даже одно участие в Олимпийских играх – это очень почетно. А быть олимпийским чемпионом.
Все сплощено, как один кулак. Так что сборная России будет олимпийским чемпионом.
Ovechkin now embodies the spirit of that deep tradition of Russian hockey. Playing for country means so much to him. He said he'd be prepared to suffer the consequences if the NHL decides to pull out of future Olympic tournaments. It caused a stir in the hockey world, especially with the next Winter Games going to Russia in 2014.
Ovechkin is a national treasure. They probably have a couple of dozen players or athletes that are considered to be the golden, what they call the golden fund of Russia, and he's revered by the entire nation.
Also in the Golden Fund is Evgeny Malkin, a teammate of Sidney Crosby's. And if he knows the secrets of Crosby's game, he'll take advantage. But that cuts both ways.
Interesting situations when you're playing against your own goaltender or your own teammate. You want to win the game, so something's going to help you win that game. You're going to share that information.
If Evgeny Malkin has the puck and his head's down, I guarantee that he's going to hit him.
After the two-day camp, the Russian players won't reunite until Vancouver. Ovechkin stays on to take care of a little business.
Here we are in Moscow, shooting photo shoots with Alex for Tabler magazine. Day is gonna be long.
Russia has produced a lot of hockey stars. But right now, Ovechkin is king in Moscow. And one of his sponsors has decided it's the perfect place to launch his new line of clothing.
It's a lifestyle component. It's very edgy and unique, similar to Alex's lifestyle. It's since transcended into something no one expected.
On the other side of the world, Sidney Crosby is also shooting promos. But somehow he missed out on the big limousine and the hot models. It's day one of Team Canada's training camp, and he's trying out for the team along with 45 other players.
This is our opportunity, and these opportunities, and especially one in your own country, Maybe we'll never come again.
Every one of these players has their own expectations and what they want to accomplish, and they're every bit the same, if not greater, than what the country expects.
The expectations for Canada couldn't be higher. After the gold in Salt Lake City, the men's team finished seventh in the last Winter Games in Turin. Only a perfect fit with the best players has any chance at this level. And Crosby knows it as well as anyone.
In the Olympics, you're talking about the best players in the world. It's going to come down to each and every player being responsible.
Right now, we're a great group of talent. We have to become a great team. It's that exciting here. It's that big a deal. I mean, everybody at my lake, they picked the team all summer, and I just got a text saying, I don't know why you're at camp. We picked the team in the paper today, and people are into it.
Crosby was still a rookie during the last Olympic Games, and he wasn't even invited to try out.
You know, I told him, you know, that he, I'm 98% sure that you're not making the team. He was very disappointed. He wanted to be on that team, there's no doubt, and he was silent. He kept it inside and wanted, you know, the team to do well. In his heart, he wanted to be there.
This time, he'll get his chance, and the burden of all the expectations that come with it.
Knowing that it's an Olympic championship, something he hasn't participated in, he will be bringing that second level.
If I was a betting man, I'm sure that he will rise to the occasion to be at his ultimate best.
And as if all that pressure isn't enough, there's also the question about the captaincy. Who will wear the C for Team Canada? And should he be the one?
If I were to picture myself playing for the Olympic team, I probably don't see it wearing the C, but if that was the case, it'd be a huge honor. But you look down that list, there's probably, you know, 10 to 15 captains on their team, so that makes, you know, for a strong locker room and a lot of character.
Team Canada coaches and management aren't saying who will be the captain, but they figure Crosby will be a leader, with or without the C.
He's a guy who is going to be a leader on this club for us, but he's going to do it not as much with talking as it is going to be with playing and executing and handling the big situations.
He doesn't have to feel the burden to do a lot other than just to be himself and go out and play the game he has to play.
Crosby is used to winning. In the minors, at the World Juniors, and now the NHL. But Olympic hockey is something special.
Guys that are goal scorers or checking now or they blocking shots, maybe they wouldn't do it before. I think it doesn't matter. They'll do whatever they have to do to win that gold medal.
I think that's always been something instilled in Canadian, you know, hockey players. You're taught growing up to kind of leave your ego at the door and make sure that you're doing what it takes for the team to win.
Vancouver, 2010. Sidney Crosby and Alexander Ovechkin will meet on Olympic ice for the first time. Fierce competitors in a rivalry that's heating up.
I remember the first couple years we played against each other, it was more kind of something that was being celebrated. You know, it was two young guys who have had success early on in their careers. And then I think it's kind of changed, you know, it's kind of evolved. It became more me against him. And I think then it turned into kind of something that was a bitter rivalry. You know, for me personally, that's the last thing I really wanted.
The games promise to be fast and intense. The stakes higher, the hits harder.
I respect him as a player, but if I had a chance to hit him or do something against him, why not?
You know, Alex is a different player than I am. He's got that physical presence, and he's tried to use on me a few times.
One thing is certain. The games they play against each other will captivate hockey fans around the world.
It's going to be an amazing time for us. It's going to be a fun time, and it's going to be a hard time. So we're going to try.
Yeah, you dream of that opportunity, so it's exciting. And you know, and realize the whole country's behind you. And basically, you want to represent them and all the guys who wore the jersey before.
Sid the Kid and Alexander the Great Hockey fans have been debating who's the better player. Soon they'll be arguing, who's the better Olympian?